Once the lights go out and the Sanctus bell sounds, the dead man walks silently into the ring with rising flames and smoke surrounding his every step. Many feared he was a ghost, while others thought he was immortal. He is a man who has accomplished what many can only dream of. He is the greatest wrestler to ever walk the earth. He is the Undertaker. The legends of the Undertaker would be told for generations and generations to come. But beneath the aesthetics, the Undertaker is just a man who conquered professional wrestling for 3 decades and counting. Stay right where you are, because this video will answer one question that's been on the minds of many WWE fans for years. Who is the Undertaker behind the trench coat, the lights and the cameras? But make sure you stick to the end, where we reveal the epic moment the dead man claimed his first WWE Championship. Let's begin. The Undertaker, whose real name is Mark William Calaway, was born in Houston, Texas on March the 24th, 1965. He grew up with his 4 older brothers and attended Waltrip High School, where he was a member of the football and basketball teams. As a child, Calaway was fascinated by mystery and scare. That fascination was enhanced by the fact that young Calaway had family members who worked in funeral homes, so he was around caskets and embalming rooms a lot. In fact, Calaway once told a story of how, as a little kid, he and his family were going to have a service, and they had already bought in the casket. The deceased was in the casket, but the service wasn't going to start for another couple of hours, so there was nobody in the chapel. Calaway summoned courage and walked up to this casket to peek in. To his very surprise, it was like the corpse inside moved. Calaway ran away and as fast as he could, but from that day it was like life was preparing him for his future. He graduated high school in 1983 and began studying on a basketball scholarship at Angelina College in Lufkin, Texas. In 1985, he enrolled in Texas Wesleyan University in Fort Worth, Texas, where he majored in sports management and played as a center for the Rams in the 1985-1986 season. In 1986, Calaway dropped out of university to focus on a career in sports and briefly considered playing professional basketball in Europe. You need to understand that this guy was standing at a staggering 6'10". He knew he had a chance at basketball, but while training at a gym to bulk up for basketball tryouts, someone mentioned a wrestling camp to him. At the time, Calaway was reluctant, but then he decided to give it a try. Getting to the wrestling camp, everyone was as big as himself. He felt he belonged there and knew right from that moment that wrestling was what he was meant to do. Calaway began training under Buzz Sawyer in late 1986. He wrestled his first match wearing a mask on June the 26th, 1987 for World Class Championship Wrestling, where he lost to Bruiser Brody at the Dallas Sportatorium. He was accompanied to the ring by Percival Percy Pringle III, who later served as his manager in the WWF as Paul Bearer. Yep, that's right, that's the man who held the urn for The Undertaker for the early part of his career, and probably made you too scared to sleep at night. Anyway, in 1989, Calaway joined World Championship Wrestling as a villain and adopted the ring name Mean Mark Callis, a name devised for him by former wrestler Terry Funk. He was portrayed as a sinister force, wearing predominantly black ring attire, and was described by announcer Jim Ross as having a fondness for pet snakes and the music of Ozzy Osbourne. But here's the crazy part. Can you believe someone once thought no one would ever pay to watch The Undertaker? That's just insane, right? Well, it did happen. During his time with the WCW, Calaway began to question his future as a wrestler after being told by company booker Ole Anderson during contract renewal discussions that nobody would ever pay money to watch him perform. That obviously meant he had to leave the promotion. So Calaway sought to achieve more noteworthy success in professional wrestling by making numerous efforts to join the World Wrestling Federation, now called the WWE. He went to many lengths to land a meeting with Vince McMahon. However, accessing and securing an interview with McMahon was very, very hard. It took Calaway trying to convince individuals acquainted with McMahon or already existing WWF talent to recommend him to the WWF, such as Hulk Hogan, Paul Heyman, and Bruce Prichard. After trying his luck, Calaway, aka The Undertaker, finally had a meeting with Mr. McMahon himself. You trust Vince not to easily buy into the hype surrounding Calaway, so he decided to go watch Calaway perform live at an event along with Paul Heyman and Prichard. Calaway had a hip injury at the time, but still he couldn't miss the match knowing Vince would be there. He put up his best performance to impress Vince. But after the match, Vince told Heyman and Prichard that he was not impressed and didn't see a need to extend a contract to Calaway. Man, it was really crazy because Paul Heyman and Bruce Prichard personally believed Calaway had what it took to become one of the best wrestlers out there. They persuaded Vince McMahon to have one final meeting with Calaway at his mansion. Thankfully, Vince agreed. Calaway was so optimistic about this meeting that he immediately sent his resignation letter to the WCW, thinking he was definitely getting a job with the WWF. After an extended hour and a half meeting, Vince McMahon ended the session by telling Calaway that the WWF had nothing for him at the time, but that maybe they would at the beginning of the coming year, January 1991. This disappointed Calaway as he had quit his job with WCW, making him jobless for however long until McMahon decided to send him an offer. But then a miracle happened. A few days later, McMahon randomly called up Calaway and asked, "Is this the Undertaker?" Calaway contemplated for a moment before responding, "Yeah, I'm the Undertaker." Vince then went on to tell him about the Old West Undertaker idea he's had in mind for years, but had never found the right wrestler to play the part. And that was it. That was how the Undertaker got his name and got his first contract with the WWE. In October 1990, Calaway signed with the WWE and was given the ring name Kane the Undertaker. He made his debut for a taping of WWE's Superstars on November the 19th, 1990, quickly defeating his very first WWF opponent, Mario Mancini. But his first televised and commonly recognized debut came on the 22nd of November 1990 at the Survivor Series Elimination Tag Match. Entering this match, the name Kane was omitted, and he was simply referred to as The Undertaker. The WWE Universe instantly loved him, and Vince decided to push him for world title contention. But before we talk about that, let's do something for you watching this video. We're doing a shout-out contest for our subscribers, so if you want to get a personal shout-out from us, go comment EPIC in the comment section below and stand a chance to win the contest. It's pretty easy, so go comment EPIC now! The Undertaker made his WrestleMania debut at WrestleMania 7 on March 24, 1991, where he defeated Superfly Jimmy Snuka. From there, he was inserted into his first major feud, which was with the Ultimate Warrior. The Undertaker would later suffer his first losses in the WWE to the Ultimate Warrior in a first ever body bag challenge, a casket match, and a standard pinfall match. The feud was, however, cut short after the Warrior's suspension and ongoing issues with Vince McMahon. In the 1991 King of the Ring, Undertaker defeated Road Warrior Animal in a qualifying match before fighting Sid Vicious to a double disqualification in the semi-final, which saw both men eliminated from the King of the Ring tournament. His next match was against Hulk Hogan for the WWF Championship at Survivor Series. Hulk started off by destroying Undertaker's casket even before the match started. The match was fought at a very slow pace, which is typically how all the Undertaker's matches were back in the 90s. With Pallbearer carrying his mysterious urn, Undertaker had the upper hand for the first few minutes of the match. But when Hulkamania came alive, he bombarded the Undertaker with a series of attacks, but was unable to hurt him. After seemingly drawing strength from the mysterious urn, the Undertaker ruthlessly dominated Hulk Hogan for the next few minutes of the match. The final moment came when Undertaker delivered his finishing tombstone piledriver to put an end to the match. But immediately after, Hulkamania showed he was no ordinary man by rising to his feet, filled with mystical strength and pumped to continue the match. He gave the Undertaker a body slam and then a big foot, but out of nowhere, Nature Boy Ric Flair came out to the ringside. Hulk Hogan immediately left the ring to attack him outside. But before Hulk Hogan could go back in to finish the Undertaker, Pallbearer seized one of Hulk's legs. When the referee got distracted and tried to push Pallbearer away, the Undertaker lifted Hulkamania one more time, and with the help of Ric Flair, who put a chair in the ring, the Undertaker gave Hulkamania a tombstone piledriver right on top of the steel chair. Right after that, the Undertaker won by pinfall and became the new WWE World Champion, his first WWE Championship and the youngest WWE Champion in history to that point, at 26 years old. Make sure you check out this other video showing on your screen. Bye, and thanks for watching.